Alright, it's rolling, bro. So we just gonna go with it.
Oh, Shalom. It's like now. We out here on the west side of Columbus. All praises. Do you have a boss? Show me your house, Shy. Double honors to the apostles, a great millstone. We just come out here, just do a little video. Hey, let's just go, things on my mind. I'm gonna go into Revelation, the 18th chapter. And we're gonna bring out some truth. Yeah, Revelation 18 and just start at 1 probably. Because what I want to do is, there's a popular doctrine out here is the people, they read Revelation the 18th chapter and it says, come out of her, my people. And I see a lot of Bible teachers on YouTube, a lot of Israelite groups. They all use this scripture to say, come out of her, my people, means that we have to go out in the wilderness. We got to get a bunch of guys together. We're going to move out. We're going to start a compound like Jim Jones or something, or like David Koresh, and we're going to get a community together. Like that was that Pastor Dow guy on YouTube. He's real popular. You know Pastor Dow? You know, he brings out some truth, huh? But he's breaking that scripture down totally wrong. Because he uses that scripture over and over again to say that everybody has to come out the city and go live with him, or go away from society and go build their own community. Man, that's not what that's talking about. That's talking about a UFO beaming us up. So we're gonna read that. Yeah, we're gonna try to read. We'll probably get interrupted. Yeah, verse 1.
Revelation 18 and verse 1. After these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon.
Okay, keep going.
Babylon the Great is fallen, it's fallen.
And America is Babylon the Great, because Babel is a Hebrew word that means confusion, and America is the land of great confusion. That's why we get confused and we're like, is that a man or a woman? I'm confused, I don't know. Your little children get confused, like, who's my daddy? Are you my daddy? Like, no, I'm not your motherfucking daddy. They better ask your mama, and she don't know. That's why she's going on Maury Povich to find out. This is the land of confusion. It's the old joke. They say, what's the most confusing day in the hood is Father's Day. That's the truth. But we keep going with that.
Come the habitation of devils, and the hold of every foul spirit, and the cage of every unclean and hateful bird. For all nations have drunk of the wine of her wrath of fornication.
Yeah, that's how we know America's Great Babylon, because all nations have drank of the wine of America. That means America's philosophies. America's going and they spreading their democracy throughout the earth, their so-called democracy. That's part of that wine. Other nations, they drinking that wine. Just like the Hollywood, all the Hollywood and music industry filth, that's getting spread across the world like HIV, and spreading like AIDS and gonorrhea. You know what I mean? Keep going. Yeah. Talking about AIDS. Oh, my fault. You know Charlie Sheen got AIDS. That was in the news. You see that?
Yeah.
He's salty now, and he ain't winning no more. Go ahead.
The kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth have waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies.
Yeah, so who is that? The merchants of the earth have waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. China's whole economy is based upon selling American merchandise and manufacturing merchandise for America and the rest of the world, mainly America. Because America has all the merchandise. All the people in America, they got smartphones, they got all these devices. These other countries around the world ain't got as much shit as we got over here. We got everything. You know what I mean? That's what, this proves America's Great Babylon. That's why the World Trade Center is where? In New York. That's why, where's the United Nations at? United Nations, coalition of all nations. That's in New York. That's in America. That's in America. Ah. America. God bless America.
heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people.
All right, he said, I heard another voice from where? From heaven. The voice came from heaven, the sky, saying, come out of her, my people. Keep going.
Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plague.
That ye receive not of her plague. What's the plague? That's that fire that's about to get rained down on America. So what, just the deal, see, America's going to be destroyed by a thermonuclear fire. And right before that destruction, the Lord is going to beam up his elect of Israel. The elect of Israel is going to beam us up. Well, he's going to save one-third of Israel, and the elect, he's going to beam us up into those so-called UFOs, spaceships, chariots. The Bible calls them chariots, you know, like a chariot of fire. And we're going to get beamed up. That's why I said there's a voice came out of heaven. Because that voice came out, that so-called UFO, out of that spaceship. And go back and read verse 1 again. Because remember, it said another voice came out of heaven. It didn't say a voice came out of heaven and said, come out of her, my people, and go into the wilderness. It didn't say that. Because a lot of people will also say that come out of her, my people, means to come out of the philosophies of America. To come out of the philosophies of Christianity, or the philosophies of the politics. And that's not what that's talking about either. You can say that spiritually, but it's literally talking about come out of her, my people. We're going to get beamed up into the ships, into the chariot. Yeah, read verse 1 again. Because this proves that this is talking about the chariots coming out of the sky.
After these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened. Lord.
Yeah, because he said the angel came down from heaven, which is the sky. Just like the Lord said, the one y'all call Jesus, whose true ancient Hebrew name is Yahweh Shai. He said he's coming back out the sky with legions of angels. That's why they said the angel is coming out of the sky. So read that again.
After these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory.
The earth was lightened with his glory, because them chariots is magnificent to behold. You know what I mean? And people, their hearts are going to fail them when they see those chariots. They're going to get scared to death. Go ahead. Keep reading that. Well, yeah, go back to the part and read it again. Come out of her, my people.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partaker of her sins, that ye receive not of her plagues.
Yeah, so that, keep going, because that's the voice came out of heaven saying that. Keep going.
For her sins have reached unto heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquities.
So God remembered the iniquities of this filthy place called America. Keep going.
Remember her even as I reward her, even as she rewarded you.
Right, keep
and
going.
Double unto her double according to her works.
Yes, double slavery, just like Revelation 13 says. Who the leadest cat in the captivity shall go into captivity. He that killed with the sword shall be killed with the sword. This payback. Just like the Lord said in Thessalonians, he's going to avenge the saints. I could get it, but keep going. Oh yeah, vengeance on those that, I need a fun name. Go ahead.
In the cup which she hath filled to her double. For how much she hath glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her. She said from her heart, I said queen and no widow. It shall see no sorrow.
Yeah, because people think, oh, America can't never be destroyed. You people, they so proud. We had the strongest military in the history of the earth. Nobody will ever destroy us. That's a proud spirit. That's why this place will be destroyed. Keep going.
Therefore shall her plagues come in one day.
Her plagues shall come in one day. All remember, because what did that earlier scripture say? It said, come out of her, my people, so you do not receive her plagues. Right? And it's going to tell you what that plague is. Keep going. Death and mourning and famine. Keep going.
She shall be utterly burned with fire.
And then she shall utterly be burned with fire. So how are you going to teach a doctrine to come out of her, my people, means we're going to go build our own communities? If everything's going to be on fire, are you going to build a community in the middle of a fire, a lake of fire? That don't make no sense, does it? So that just proves that myth. There's people that don't know the Bible, man. Keep going.
For strong is the Lord God who judgeth her.
Yeah, keep going.
And And the kings of the earth who have committed fornication and lived deliciously with her shall dwell her and lament for her when they shall see the smoke of her burning.
The smoke of the burning, the whole country is going to be on fire, bro.
Standing afar off for the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, for the great city Babylon, that mighty city, when 1 hour is that judgment come.
So 1 hour that judgment comes, just like that, boom. So how you going to come out of her, the whole place is going to be destroyed within an hour. That don't make no sense. Keep going.
The merchants of the earth shall weep and mourn over her, for no man buyeth their merchandise anymore.
Yeah, don't nobody want your shit, man. Keep going.
Merchandise of gold, silver, and precious stones and pearls, and fine linen, and purple, and silk, and scarlet, and all dyeing wood, and all manner vessels of ivory, and all manner vessels of most precious wood, and of brass, and iron, and marble, and cinnamon, odors, and ornaments, and frankincense, and wine, and oil.
Yeah, because in America, you can get anything. Like I said, that's why the World Trade Center is in New York. That's where all the trading is going down. That's where all the deals are being made for merchandise. Keep going.
And fine flour, and wheat, and beasts, and sheep, and horses, and chariots, and slaves, and souls of men. And the fruits that thy soul lusteth after are departed from thee. And all things which were daunted are goodly are departed from thee. And thou shalt find them no more at all.
It ain't going to be nothing left over here but ashes, smoke, death, fire, brimstone. That's what's going to be over here. Keep going.
The merchants of these things which were made rich by her shall stand afar off for the fear of her torment, weeping and wailing, and saying, alas, alas, that great city that was clothed in fine linen and purple and scarlet and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, for in 1 hour so great riches has come to naught. Every shipmaster and all the company ships, sailors, right, as many as trade by sea stood afar off and cried when they saw the smoke of her burning, saying, what city is like unto this great city? And they cast dust on their heads and cried, weeping and wailing, saying, alas, alas, that great city, where it was much rich, all that had ships in the sea by reason of her costliness.
Yeah, so you know that's talking about America. America is Great Babylon. That's why it's going to be destroyed. The Lord's going to destroy all this shit. You see all these cars, all these people, all these filthy-ass heathenistic people, they're going to get burned up, man. All these dumb-ass women out here running their mouth, talking shit to their husband, they're going to get burnt the fuck up, and their little nasty-ass children are going to get burned up right along with them. Your baby's mama's gonna get burned up. Their nasty ass, fat ass grandma's gonna get burned up. Your retarded auntie that said that eating pork is not a sin, she's getting burned up. Anybody who come against the word of the Lord is getting burned up.
Pastor.
Oh, Pastor Chitlins and Pastor Pork Chop, he getting burnt the hell up. Preaching sweet Jesus, you're gonna die. He going.
And rejoice over her, thou heaven, and ye holy apostles and prophets.
Yeah, we're going to rejoice. We're going to jubilate. What's the word?
That's bad.
Yeah, we're going to have fun. We're going to drink wine and sing the song of Moses. We're going to be happy to see this shit destroyed. Right, this is like living in hell. This is Hades right here. We're living goddamn Hades. That's why the scripture said Hades is going to be cast into the lake of fire. We're living in Hades. You know what I'm saying? And the lake of fire is America. The lake of fire is not hell. The lake of fire is America after it gets destroyed by a thermonuclear fire. It's going to be beautiful. And then we're going to be up in the chariot. We get beamed up in that chariot. The Lord going to beam us up. And then we're looking down while we're flying up in the sky. The Lord's going to say, come out of her, my people. We'll get beamed up like Scotty. Boom! Beamed up, then we'll be chilling, we'll be looking down, and all we're going to see is fire. That's a lake of fire. Huh? Mama was looking at us like we was crazy, huh?
Yeah.
Damn, fuck these hoes, man. These bitches ain't shit. We got no love for them. The woman is the number one person who will come against you. They look at you like you're crazy.
You got one more
scripture? No, I'm going to read it all. Okay. Oh, go ahead.
Isaiah 51:6, lift up your eyes to the heavens and look upon the earth beneath. And for the heavens shall vanish away like smoke, and the earth shall wax old like a garment, and they that dwell therein shall die in like manner. But my salvation shall be forever, and my righteousness shall be established.
That's a good scripture that goes hand in hand with Revelation. Because the Old Testament complements the New Testament. They complement each other. Because when the Lord said, I come in a volume of the book, there's not a single contradiction in this book. People, the Bible's riddled with contradictions. No, you just don't know nothing. You're retarded.
When my
back
spreads like a Revelation 18:20, rejoice over it, thou heaven, and ye holy apostles and prophets, for God has avenged you on earth.
Oh yeah, so the Lord's gonna avenge the prophets. You know what I'm saying? Because people come up talking shit to us. Back in our previous lives, we were stoned to death, had our heads cut off, crucified. I mean, they crucified the Son of God. Put him on the cross, talked shit, taunted him, heckled him. You know what I mean? So what do you think the Lord's going to do when he comes back? He's going to tread the winepress. He's going to be a whole lot of death and a whole lot of destruction. Keep going.
And a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone.
So the mighty angel took up a stone and that great millstone. Keep going.
And cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down.
Yeah, with great violence. With violence. Violence. That's a good word. Violence. That's the Lord that said that. So what the Lord is telling you, when the Son of the Most High returns, but thus with violence. Read that again.
Cast into the sea, saying, thus with violence.
With violence.
Shall that great city Babylon be thrown down, and shall be found no more at all.
So there ain't gonna be no more America. So how you gonna say, come out of her, my people, means to go set up your own community? And Babylon's gonna be no more at all. That don't make no sense, does it? That's talking about those UFOs, them starships. That's the chariot of fire. We're gonna get beamed up. That's how the Lord's gonna deliver us. Just like in the Exodus, during the Exodus, the Lord led Moses and the Israelites through the Red Sea, and he used a chariot, a so-called UFO, to do it. That's why they call it a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. You know what I mean? Oh, look, that's good, man. I got a scripture to back it up about the chariots. Let me read this Exodus 19. I'm going to go back to the Exodus. You can read it if you want. Yeah, you can read it. Exodus 19 and something. And 22. After the Ten Commandments. If you ever read the Ten Commandments in Exodus, the 20th chapter, you got to read the whole chapter. When you go to the very bottom of the chapter, it speaks of the Lord's chariots. But we're going to back it up a chapter to the chapter 19, Exodus 19. Let's see where you should start. Where you can figure anywhere out to start. The whole chapter is pretty long. Anywhere where it starts talking about don't come close and die. I'm trying to find my Bible pages are all stuck together. Hold on. Yeah, hold on. Yeah. Where you at, 19? Yeah, it started 17.
Exodus 19:17. Moses brought forth the people out of the camp to meet with God. They stood at the neither part of the mountain.
Now he said to meet with God, right? So this is when Moses and the Israelites were out in the wilderness, out in the Sinai desert, right? Keep going.
And Mount Sinai was all together on its smoke.
Now Mount Sinai was smoking. All right, keep going.
But Yahweh descended upon it in the smoke.
He said Yahweh, which says the Lord in the English Bible. Anytime you see the word Lord in all capital letters in your English Bible, when you look that word up in the Hebrew, it's God's name. the Most High, the Heavenly Father's name, which is Yahweh, Y-H-W-H. People call him Yahweh or Jehovah. Those are incorrect pronunciations. The proper way to pronounce is Yahweh, okay? So read that again.
And Mount Sinai was altogether on smoke, because Yahweh descended upon it in fire, and the smoke thereof descended as the smoke of a furnace, and the whole mount quaked greatly.
So it said the Most High descended on top of the mountain in a fire. That's talking about his chariot. People are like, why does God need that? You know, that means God's an alien? You're saying God's an alien? No. He ain't no goddamn alien. He's the Most High. He created the planet, the universe. He created everything. Keep going.
And the voice of the trumpet sounded long and waxed longer and longer. Moses spake, and God answered him by a voice. And Yahweh came down upon Mount Sinai on the top of the mountain. And Yahweh called Moses up to the top of the mountain, and Moses went up, and Yahweh said unto Moses, go down, charge the people, lest they break through unto Yahweh to gaze, and many of them perish. And let the priests also which come near to Yahweh sanctify themselves, lest Yahweh break forth upon them. And Moses said unto Yahweh, the people cannot come up to Mount Sinai, but thou chargest us, saying, let set bonds about the mountain and sanctify it. And Yahweh said unto him, away, get thee down, and thou shalt come up, thou and Aaron with thee, and let not the priest and the people break them to come up unto Yahweh, lest he break forth upon them. So Moses went down unto the people, his back unto them.
Yeah, keep going, there's more to it, man. Yeah, we'll just go right, we're gonna read them all.
And God spake unto all these words, saying, I am Yahweh.
Hold up, read the chapter number, because we went to the Exodus 20th chapter. This is the Ten Commandments. We about to break down the Ten Commandments, and we're going to prove to you that America is the kingdom of Satan.
Exodus 21. And God spake all these words, saying, I am Yahweh, thy God, which hath brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Oh, the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Hold up, you got any money on you? The house. I got a dollar bill right here. Egypt is the house of bondage. That's why America was formed on hardcore slavery. And that's why there's a pyramid on the back of a dollar bill, because America is spiritually known as Egypt. Okay, and also, you see that? That's the pyramid with the all-seeing eye of Horus. Horus was an Egyptian god. And Horus was represented by a falcon, a bird. Jupiter was also represented by a bird. That's why the Romans carried eagles in the battle. But that's a whole nother story. But America is spiritually known as Egypt. Okay? That's why they got an obelisk in Washington, D.C. called the Washington Monument, which represents Osiris's penis. Now, we could go on all day with this Egyptian symbolism that they use in America. But there you go. Read that, because Egypt's the house of bondage. And you got a lot of fools saying all the great wisdom and knowledge and mathematics and science all come from ancient Egypt. That's madness. The only thing that come from ancient Egypt is heathens. The only people that did anything good in Egypt was the Israelites. Because we was the ones in slavery building the pyramids. Go ahead. Yeah, because aliens didn't build the pyramids, okay? The Israelites built the pyramids. You best believe that. Because it was Abraham that made Egypt great. Egypt didn't have no science and technology until Abraham went there, coming up out, you know, from the east. Keep going.
Thou shalt have no gods before me.
Oh, so we're gonna compare the Bible to America. The Bible says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. But in America, what does the First Amendment say? You got freedom of religion. You can worship whatever you want. We got goddamn Muslims walking around. We just came from the library. It looked like we was in Saudi Arabia or Baghdad up in there. Bitches walking around with that bullshit. Goddamn Muslims everywhere you look. Muslims are heathen, okay? A heathen is a slave. They supposed to be our servant, bowing down to the earth with their face in the dust. But, you know, in America, you could be a Muslim. And here it is, Muslims blowing shit up all over the place. They gonna keep on shipping more Muslims in here. Obama just said he's gonna ship in, what, another 10,000 soon? Something like that. This is all part of the, because soon watch, there's gonna be Muslims at blowing shit up in America. That's what the government wants, you know what I mean? The government's funding ISIS in the Middle East. Donald Trump, I heard him say it twice. He says it all the time. He said the government was funding ISIS. I mean, everybody knows this, it ain't no secret. They had congressional hearings when people was asking how come the United States is funding ISIS? Why are we giving weapons to ISIS? But go ahead. Oh yeah, but you can worship Satan in America. The first commandment says, thou shalt have no other gods. In America, you can worship the devil. The Church of Satan was formed in San Francisco by Anton LaVey, a so-called Jew, an Edomite. So you know America ain't right. Keep going.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image.
Oh, no graven images. But Christmas is coming up. They're going to have Santa Clauses everywhere. And Santa Claus, all that is a... It's really with Odin. The whole tradition of Christmas, of Santa Claus. Santa Claus is really Father Winter, who is Odin. And he wears a little owl cap too. You see how if you get on Google, type in Baal. Go to Wikipedia, type in Baal. Baal wore the little pointed hat. You know, Baal, like the devil, Satan in the Bible. Baal was known to wear a pointed hat with a ball on top of it, just like Santa Claus and the little elves. And the Christmas tree, actually the Christmas tree represents the tree of knowledge of good and evil that was in the Garden of Eden. That the Most High said, you're not supposed to eat of that fruit. And that's why the Christmas tree got bulbs all over it. Those bulbs, those are fruit. That's some shiny fruit. You know, the fruit that looks good to the eye. And the Lord said, don't eat that fruit. That's the fruit that the serpent gave to Eve. So pretty much, when you celebrate Christmas, you're worshiping Baal. You're worshiping the devil. You worship the serpent. Oh, go ahead. That's cool. I like that.
Acts 17:25. Neither is worship with man's hands, as though he needed anything, seeing he gives to all life and breath and all things, have made of one blood all nations of men for to go on the face of the earth, and have determined the time before appointed in the bounds of their habitation, that they should seek the Lord if happily they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from every one of us. Okay, let's get to 29. For as much then as we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the Godhead is like unto gold, silver, or stone, or graven by art and man's device. In the times of ignorance, God winked at, but now commanded all men everywhere to repent.
Yeah, that's what we out here. The scriptures say what? Go out, teach the gospel to all nations. Tell people to repent, saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You can't repent unless you didn't know you was doing wrong. A lot of people really think Christmas is they think that's in the Bible. They actually, because they never read the Bible, they think there's probably a scripture in there somewhere that says put up a Christmas tree. It don't say that. Jeremiah, the 10th chapter, says don't put Christmas trees up. I got a precept for that tree too. Genesis 3:1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, you shall not surely die, because the serpent's the devil, he's lying. And the serpent's not actually a snake, it's a wicked man. The same wicked spirit that was in Cain was in the serpent. The same wicked spirit that's in Esau was in the serpent. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die, For God doth know that in the days ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. That's the point I wanted to get. Remember I said, if you look at the Christmas tree, and that represents the tree, the knowledge of good and evil. As you see the little bulbs, you see how they be shining? They be looking all nice. They put the lights on it, the silver and gold. But it said, when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and the tree to desire to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her and did eat. And the eyes of them both were open, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. But we know that was wicked and evil. They wasn't supposed to eat that fruit. The Most High come. That was really the first sin in the Bible. They didn't obey the commandments. So that's why you see the woman's always the one into decorating that tree too. You don't never see the husband like baby. Well, actually you probably do. But you know, usually it's the woman who's into decorating the tree. They put the bulbs on it, it'd be perfect. They be messing with it for hours. You know what I'm saying? And the Christmas tree got nothing to do with the Bible. The Bible said you're supposed to burn them with fire. Because over there in Europe, they know it's pagan. If you go to Scandinavia to this day, they still call Christmas trees Yule trees, which goes back to Yuletide, which is a pagan custom, which goes way back to the ancient world. You know what I'm saying? But let's get back to the Ten Commandments.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of or anything.
Oh yeah, well the Christmas tree is a graven image. Santa Claus is a graven image. You know the reindeer, that goes back to I believe Artemis was represented by, she's the goddess of the hunt, represented by deer, reindeer, or maybe not reindeer, but deer for sure. We'll go ahead. And how many, I believe originally, how many reindeer were there? Were there 8 reindeer? Which goes back to, like, yeah, because 8, I'm pretty sure there's 8. I'm not sure, I'm going to look it up. I remember Odin had a horse with 8 legs. We'll go ahead. It's all paganism.
But that is in earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth, thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them.
All that is just like people walk around, they got their crucifixes with that little fake Jesus on it, the Caesar Borgia necklaces. And every time they're in trouble, they're holding their necklace, kissing it. Like, what's that necklace going to do for you?
Can't they put one finger through
the belt? Yeah. This shit was made in China.
Yeah, Chinese.
This shit probably got lead painted. You might make you sick.
How would that God, him a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children until the third and fourth generation?
Yeah, because yeah, you get punished for something you did now. Your children's children might get punished for it. And we get punished now for the sins of our fathers. Our forefathers still getting punished to this day. Keep going.
Of them that hate me, and show mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of Yahweh thy God in vain.
Yeah, that don't mean saying God damn. Because God is not God's name. Okay? He just said God's name. It is not God. Saying God damn this, we actually want God to damn shit. But taking the Lord's name is vain is a you calling on the Lord, calling on his name, praying for wicked shit. You gonna pray to the Lord that you can get some money and riches. You know what I mean? You calling on the name of the Lord to do something wicked. You know, that's pretty much what it is. Keep going. Or when you just mocking the Lord, you say his name, like, say the Lord ain't shit. You know, what's he gonna do? That's taking the Lord's name, but he'll kill you.
We're saying
okay. If you say he don't got a name. Man, yep. That proves that the Lord's name is important. If people say God's name is not important, then how come in one of the Ten Commandments it said don't take the Lord's name in vain? It actually says don't take Yahweh's name in vain. They don't say Lord in the original Hebrew. That's a good point.
Remember the Sabbath day.
Hold up. Compared to America, though. Oh yeah, no, we'll just go to the next one. Yeah, read that again. What else? Yeah, the Sabbath.
Okay. Remember the Sabbath to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou work, labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of Yahweh thy God.
Oh yeah, so in America there's no Sabbath. All this shit right here, these stores, they open 7 days a week. Kroger does never shut down. Okay, but the Bible says you're supposed to get a day of rest where nobody works, everything, the whole city shuts down. So everybody can get rested. That's how we know America's a kingdom of Satan, a kingdom of slavery. There's no rest out here. This shit just goes nonstop every day. Just continually. There's no rest. You know what I'm saying? What's that? Yeah, Walmart stays open every day. They don't never shut down. That totally goes against the commandments of the Lord. That's why we know America is the kingdom of Satan. Because actually, back in the old days, going back even 50 years ago, nothing was open on Sundays. Well, even though Sunday's not the real Sabbath, the Sabbath comes in with the new moon, according to the lunar cycles and the lunar calendar. The Saturday and Sunday is not the Sabbath. The Sabbath is determined by when the new moon is. The first Sabbath of the month is on the new moon. Then the next Sabbath is 7 days after the new moon. And so on to the next month. Keep going with that. And there ain't no Sabbath out here. There's no rest. There's no rest for the wicked.
Thou shalt do no, shalt do any work. Nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gate. For 6 days thou hast made earth.
Yeah, even the slaves are supposed to get a break. The servants, even they're supposed to get a break. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, in the kingdom of heaven, even we're going to have slaves. We're going to have a lot of slaves. But they still, on the Sabbath, they're not going to be working. Keep going.
For in 6 days Yahweh made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is therein, there is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore Yahweh blessed the seventh day and hallowed it. Honor thy father and thy mother, that thou days.
Honor thy father and mother. That's hard to do when you don't know who your father is. Yeah.
Day may be long upon the land which Yahweh thy God giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not commit adultery.
Oh, commit adultery, hold up. It's legal in America to commit adultery. It's not against the law, there's no punishment for it. Actually, the Bible, according to the Bible, adultery is punishable by death. That's Leviticus 20 and 10, go look it up, all right? Leviticus 20 and 10 says the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death. But in America, since this is the kingdom of Satan, everything's backwards. So here, a woman can leave her husband, commit adultery, go have sex with 100 different men, you know what I mean? And then she can leave her husband and get child support, alimony, and the man don't pay, he gets locked up. That's totally backwards. She's supposed to get put to death. But in America, she gets rewarded. She'll get, for committing adultery, a horse woman in America will get rewarded with child support, EBT card, Section 8 housing. She gets rewarded for committing adultery. Because adultery is encouraging. It's in all the music you listen to. All the songs are about adultery. All the movies that these women watch and all these TV shows these women watch, especially the soap operas and all the shows, not just the soap operas. It's in all the shows. You name a show, it's got adultery in it, and it's justifying the adultery. Like it's okay. So that's how we know this is the kingdom of Satan. Keep going.
Thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant.
Oh, that kid covered the neighbor's wife. Whatever every rap song talks about. Somebody, that's why I fucked your bitch. Yeah, I watch your girl when you're around me. That's all they talk about. Why I hear somebody playing that, I just pray that the Lord kills them. Okay.
Nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is in thy neighbors. That is thy neighbors.
Now keep going.
All the people saw the thunderings and the lightning.
Is there this part we really want to get to talk about the UFOs again? Ha!
The noise of the trumpet and the mountain smoking.
The mountain smoke. See, this is, when you go to your grandma's house and she got the Ten Commandments on the wall, how come that part right here is not on? It just cuts it off. They give you those, but then they just cut this part off. So read that. Read that again.
And all the people saw the thunders, the lightning, the noise of the trumpet, and the mountain smoking. And when the people saw it, they removed and stood afar off. And they said unto Moses, speak thou with us, and we will hear. But let not God speak with us, lest we die.
Because the most, yeah, first they begged the Most High to talk to him. So he talked to him. They got so scared. They're like, oh, no, let's talk to Moses. That's what Israel for.
They said, Moses said unto the people, fear not, for God has come to prove you that his fear may be upon your faces, that ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moses drew near unto the thick darkness where God was.
That thick darkness. That's that chariot on top of Mount Sinai. What people would call, if they seen one, they go, oh, that's a UFO. Well, that's a chariot of fire. You know what I'm saying? God ain't no damn alien. Okay, that's a chariot of fire. You'll know if you see it. You'll find out all about it. Talk shit. Laugh at us. All right. That's why Israelites, they were afraid. And that's why I said in Exodus 19, we just read it, that if the Israelites got too close, then they would die from the heat, from the blast. What you got? I was about to get Isaiah 66. Go ahead.
Isaiah 31 and 5. As birds flying, so will Yahweh of hosts defend Jerusalem. Defend it also, he will deliver it. Passing over, he will preserve it.
Passing over? Yeah, in that chariot. Well, what does this mean? Because you link that up, that Mount Sinai was on fire, it was smoking. And it said the Lord descended from the heavens in Exodus 19. He descended from the heaven onto the top of the mountain. Now read this, and you read this and it makes sense. Isaiah 66 and 15. For behold, Yahweh will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will Yahweh plead with all flesh, and the slain of Yahweh shall be many. Like I said, Yahweh, that's the name of the Lord. We like to magnify the Lord's name. That's what time we get. So the Lord said, the chariots, it said the slain of the Lord shall be many. And he coming out the sky with chariots. Oh, I got more. They don't believe me. I got more. Let's see how many UFOs. They're endless. You can't get them all. You got to make multiple videos. There's more than that. Which ones you got? You got some with 18 in there? Oh, dude. Yeah, there you go. You got some 68? It's right here. I used to have all my cheap cards. We're gonna bust them out. Oh, here, I got a good one, a real quick one, a Revelation. Talking about the Revelation 1 and 7. This is talking about the one they call Jesus. His true ancient Hebrew name is Yahweh Shai. It says, behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. So the cloud is talking about the chariot. If you don't believe me, I'll get it. I got a precept to prove the clouds are chariots. You know where that's at? Psalms 104. Yeah, let me read this one real quick, just so I can break down that cloud part. Psalms 104 and 1. If I can get it. Psalms 104 and 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty. Who covers thyself with light as a garment, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain, who laid the beams of his chambers in the waters who go to outer space, who maketh the clouds his chariot, who walketh upon the wings of the wind, who maketh his angel spirits his ministers a flame of fire. But it said the Lord, he make the clouds his chariot. That's why in Revelation it said the Lord, he said, behold, he cometh with clouds. And all everyone's going to wail because of it. He's going to come back and he's going to be stomping heads like grapes. His garment's going to be drenched in blood.
Mark 8:38. Of course, at the bottom.
Yeah, that's a good scripture.
Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me, and if my words is adulterous and sinful generation.
Oh! That's a cut to these fools. People come up, they're like, oh, if the Bible don't say Jesus is going to kill people, like, yes, it does. It's right here, 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 right here. They're like, nah, that's your interpretation. Okay, read that again.
Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and my words is an adulterous and sinful generation.
It's an adulterous, sinful generation, a filthy, foul generation. Keep going.
Of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed.
So the Lord gonna be ashamed of you fools. Keep going.
When he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels.
When he comes with the glory of the Father with the holy angels. They're coming out the sky. Does it go into that anymore?
Nah, that's it.
I got another one. Let's go back to the Oh yeah, we get that one. It's proven. It's go to all chariots, man. That's what time we in. Soon the Lord's gonna appear on the earth. Psalm 68. That's 68, right? Yeah. Psalm 68:17. The chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. The Lord is among them as in Sinai in the holy place. We just read that. Just as in Sinai, we read what happened on Mount Sinai. It said that the Lord descended out the heavens in a flaming, burnished fire onto the top of the mountain. So this said, just like you see the Mount Sinai, that's how the angels is rolling too. That's crazy. It said the chariots of God are 20,000. Even thousands of angels. Stick to the scriptures, we'll be all right. The Lord is among them as a Sinai in the holy place. Thou hast ascended on high. Thou hast led captivity captive. Thou hast received gifts from men. I mean, that was the point right there. I'm about to skip down to here. I'm going to skip down to Psalm 68:33. To him that rideth upon the heavens of heavens. What's the heaven of heavens? I mean, the heavens and sky. So what's the heavens of heavens? That's the sky, outer space, and beyond. You know what I mean? To the bugged out places that you can't imagine. Okay? Yeah, ain't none of y'all been to outer space. Motherfuckers think they fly. Have you been to outer space? Nah. You motherfuckers love to talk shit, ain't you? It probably will die soon. To him that rideth upon the heavens of heavens, which were of old, he doth send out his voice, and that a mighty voice. Ascribe ye strength unto God, his excellency is over Israel, and his strength is in the clouds. O God, thou art terrible out of thy holy places. The God of Israel is he that giveth strength and power unto his people. Blessed be God. No, really, it's blessed be Allah, which is a title for God. Yeah. Yeah, that's a bad scripture, right, man. It said the Lord is terrible out his holy places.
Whew. Terrible.
Oh, the Lord is love. Just like you read in that one. What's that scripture you read? To those that fear him.
Oh, yeah.
To those that fear him, he's all love. You know what I mean? If you don't fear the Lord, what you think you gonna get in return? Yeah, you gonna get fucking shit upon. I got more. We gotta go back to the New Testament though. Cause it proved it. Cause really, cause you ever watch all these ancient alien shows on the History Channel and shit? And they like to use the Bible, the Book of Ezekiel, to prove that UFOs are real and shit. But they'll never touch the New Testament. Cause there's tons of UFO scriptures in the New Testament. But they don't want to lead you in that direction. You know what I mean? Because it's a totally anti-Christ documentary series they got going. All the ancient alien TV shows, that's just of the devil. That's Satan. Ancient alien, that's the devil. What's that dude's name? Eric Von Daniken's the devil. He's Satan. That Jew bastard that died, Zachariah Sitchin, he's the goddamn devil. David Icke is the devil. Name some more than clowns. Michael Tassari, he's the devil. All them Anunnaki people. What you got? Oh, go ahead, bring it up.
Ecclesiastes 43:29. The Lord is terrible and very great, marvelous in his work and his power.
Right, the Lord is terrible. He's very great. The Lord is the king, like the book of Job says, he's the king of terrors. You know what I'm saying? Y'all want to be afraid of Al-Qaeda? Shit. That ain't shit. The Most High is the one terror. He created Al-Qaeda. You know what I'm saying? The Lord, he about to bring all kind of terror to the earth. You gonna make you shit yourself. I'm just more UFOs to. Cause remember, we started this video off by saying what? The come out of her, my people, was talking about the chariots. You know what I'm saying? Oh, go ahead. That's the spirit. That's how the spirit do it.
Revelation 11,